Far, far away in the land of galoots, where the biggle-bag trees bear their biggle-bag fruits, and far lily bushes all blossom in yellow, and thimbuttle plants squirt snooberry jello. Here, where the mountains of Rocky Magoo rise high o'er the meadows of Gilda Manju, where sunsets are painted with purple and blue, you'll find a small town, not much bigger than you.
It's a wonderful tale, and it's a nugget that tells all of us that we are uniquely made, each and every one of us.
The Snoodles tale is, for me, a really special story. I had this picture in my head of this little parable that I wanted to craft in this little world, and the goal was not just, you know, how would Phil tell that story, but the goal was, how would Dr. Seuss tell that story? This was a story where it was more about the message. Kids come into the world, and they want to do everything, and they think they can do everything, because no one has told them they can't. But then as they grow, you know, eventually peers come into the picture. And when peers come into the picture, the messages they've gotten back have changed as they go to other people and ask the question, what did I look like when I did that? That instead of, you know, that was great, that was wonderful, you look beautiful. The messages all of a sudden as you get older start to change to, you know what, you look silly when you did that, or you looked foolish when you did that. But ultimately, we can't draw our self-image from our peers. We need to draw it from our Creator, because only the one who made us can see us the way we truly are. Only when you see yourself the way God sees you do you have a true picture. And that is so freeing, you know, that's how you can sing, that's how you can dance, that's how you can soar.
Well, right now, we're working on a really fun story. It's called The Sumo of the Opera. And it's basically, if you took the Mikado and Rocky and maybe tossed in a little WWF.
If you want to know who we are wrestlers of Japan.
Larry the Cucumber plays a sumo wrestler named the Italian Scallion.
That's no clown. It's his sparring partner, the Italian Scallion.
And that's his introduction. In each of our shows, we have what we call a nugget of truth, and it's a biblical value that we hope kids will pull out of the lesson. And in the Sumo of the Opera, the lesson is perseverance.
You never finish anything unless it's a punchline.
There's actually three stories in this. The Sumo of the Opera is the main story, and then we have a little silent film called Going Up, which is kind of a takeoff on The Three Stooges. And then we have a completely new story, which is told in a segment, a new segment we have called Lutfi's Fanciful Flannelgraph. And Lutfi is a sock puppet that's done by Khalil, the caterpillar. And we've got all these three stories plus a silly song, Schoolhouse Polka. Larry has an accordion and a lesson to teach about vocabulary, but all done in polka style, so it's really kind of fun. It's hilarious, and you know, I think it's one of the best things we've ever done.
Big Idea presents
The Ballad of Little Joe.
The good news is that this is a Western.
Hello, little doggy.
The bad news is that our hero runs into a string of bad luck.
This does not look good.
The good news is that he never gives up hope.
You did it, little Joe. Now we're ready for anything.
Bad things happen to good people, and a cucumber in a Stetson is going to show you why.
Crazy, huh?
Only VeggieTales could tell the story of Joseph like this.
Yippee-ki-yay-ki-yay, today is a special day.
The Ballad of Little Joe, including a silly song featuring boys in the sink.
Baby.
Available on video and DVD from the studios of Big Idea. Stay tuned after our main presentation for a special bonus feature.
Okay, Larry, it's time for the theme song.
Yeah, Bob. What do I do?
Let's see. I know. You play the guitar.
Bob, I don't have any hands.
Oh, you're right. Well, okay. Well, you play this.
I don't want to play that. I'll look silly.
Oh, come on. It'll be fun.
Nope. Not gonna do it.
It's for the kids.
Oh, okay. But they better not laugh.
All right, better get on out there.
If you like to talk to tomatoes, if a squash can make you smile, if you like to waltz with potatoes up and down the produce aisle, have we got a show for you.
Magic Tales, 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 Magic Tales.
Broccoli, celery, gotta be
Magic Tales.
Lima beans, collard greens, peachy keen,
Magic Tales.
Cauliflower, sweet and sour, half an hour,
Veggie Tales. There's never a rare show like Veggie Tales. There's never a rare show like Veggie Tales. It's time for Veggie Tales.